When you see the pricing on a large sign outside of a community, and it might say prices starting in the low 400s, and you think, woohoo, my budget's in the mid 400s, so I'm good to go. I love this builder, I love this community, I love everything. I should be able to get something here that I love. Well, maybe you can and maybe you can't. There's a lot more to new construction than that base price tag that you see on those large signs at the front of the community. Hi, I'm Jill Thomas with Berkshire Hathaway Home Services Florida Realty, and today I want to share with you 6 things you need to know about new construction, and they all have to do with money. What is better than that new car smell? A new home smell. The drywall, the wood, the fresh paint. And if you're in the Sarasota Bradenton market, you're going to see it everywhere. If you're thinking about buying new, here are 6 new construction money things you need to know. Number 1, the lot fees. Besides the base price of the home, there's going to be what's called a lot fee or a lot premium if you're getting a single family home. This does not apply to condominiums. As you can imagine, some lots are better than others, whether it's backed up to a road, a preserve, a lake, or some type of water view. And then there's some lots that are on a curve of the road and it's pie-shaped and it gives you a lot more space between you and your neighbors. So that's going to be more money as well. Now, how much the lot fees or those lot premiums are will depend on the community. They can be as low as a couple $1,000s, and in luxury communities, they could be $100,000 or more. So think about that too. Besides the base price, you've got a lot fee. The second thing to think about are those options or upgrades, and this is the fun part. Now, you do need though to be diligent in understanding what's included in the base price of the home and what are these upgrades. And every builder is different. And even the same builder might be different from community to community. So just because you see a builder in one area, do not assume that those what you've learned at that first community is gonna apply to the next one that you're in. So after you walk through that gorgeous model home that's been professionally decorated and designed, it could be quite sobering to realize what is not included. There may be structural options like adding a third stall to the garage or a loft. And then there's those pretty options like cabinets and flooring. These are the important things to really ask about when you're looking at new construction. Ask about the lighting, the electric, plumbing, outdoor features, and flooring. Some builders will charge for every place a light fixture will go. So whether you want a ceiling fan or a chandelier in a room or in a hallway, others will say, okay, we're gonna give you so many, and then after that, you have to pay for them. So that's an example of something you need to ask about, and it's gonna be different from builder to builder. Now let me say, there's a couple builders out there who don't offer any upgrades or options. It is what it is. But this is what keeps the prices lower and a bit more reasonable, so they just really crank out those homes. Now, the costs for the lot premiums, those lot fees, and upgrades, and your options can be financed. That's gonna be rolled into the price when you get the loan, and the house has to appraise, you know, based on all of those options and features that you're paying for. Now, number 3, the third thing, the dock stamps on the deed or the transfer tax. At least I know in the state of Florida, I'm not sure how it works in the other states. In resale, these dock stamps is something that the seller will always pay. But with new construction, the buyer always pays this. And it's a formula. It's 0.007% of the purchase price, or $7 for every $1,000 of the purchase price. This is gonna be paid at closing and cannot be financed. Now I'm gonna share with you a few other random additional fees that a community may or may not have. Number 1, it's not unusual if a builder just charges what they call a builder's fee. And it can be anywhere from a few $100s to a few $1,000s. Another additional fee that you might have is if in the community that you're buying into offers a lot in terms of amenities, it's not unusual if they charge what is called a one-time capital contribution fee. So this is money that just goes towards all those fun things that you have in your community, and then to keep everything up and looking nice. And this might even apply into resale communities or the resales in those communities as well, just not when somebody first buys into it as new construction. And this fee, this one-time capital contribution fee, could be a few hundred dollars or even $5,000. I have somebody who's under contract for a little condo that's in the low 200s, and it's a $4,500 capital contribution fee. And then the third potential additional fee that I've seen is something called irrigation connection, of all things. And this can be around $1,000 to $2,000. I typically see it at $1,500 if they have that. So the irrigation fee. Now, all of these fees that I just mentioned are due at closing and they are not financed. So we have to be prepared for that. Now, you might be thinking, yikes, with all these fees, who can afford to buy a new construction? Well, keep in mind, not all these builders charge all these fees, but I'm going to share with you something that might be able to help you. The fifth thing to think about with new construction are incentives from the builder. Most builders will offer some type of incentives to the buyers, and these usually come in the form of credits towards closing costs. I've also seen where, like in a newer area, where they were offering half off of structural changes as well, just because they wanted to give extra incentives to get the ball rolling in their community. Now, keep in mind, if you take advantage of the builder's incentives, you are going to be required to use their preferred title company to close and a preferred lender if you're getting financing. Now, these preferred title companies and lenders usually charge a little bit more money than what I've seen if people are purchasing a resale. And if a buyer has gotten pre-approved with a local lender, they see what the fees are, what they're up against, and then they get the fees from the preferred lender, it can be a little frustrating. But typically, the incentives you get from that builder more than make up for those little bit of extra fees, and then also some of the fees I mentioned in point four, whether it's a builder's fee or capital contribution or the irrigation fee. So that's what's really nice, are those incentives from the builder. Now, the sixth thing about new construction, and maybe my favorite, is that you can use a realtor when you buy new construction, and it doesn't cost you a penny more for doing that. In fact, builders love real estate agents. Pre-COVID, builders would drop off marketing materials and goodies to all the real estate offices because they want us to bring buyers to them. There's so much competition with new construction, so they want to work with real estate agents. And like I said before, it doesn't cost you a penny more. It's so nice to have an extra set of eyes, somebody that can help you negotiate to get you a better deal, maybe better incentives. They review everything you sign. They help you keep track of deadlines, help with the walkthroughs, the whole process. There are so many reasons to have a real estate agent on your side. Now, the sales agents that work for the builders are so nice and helpful, but it's great to have somebody who's looking out for you 100% throughout the process, looking out for your best interests. And just yesterday, I emailed a woman who's now under contract with new construction, and I was kind of giving her a timeline through the whole process of what to anticipate. And she was so relieved that I emailed her, and just knowing that I'm there to help her through all of that, what to look for, what to expect, how picky you can get, which I can get pretty picky about things. And so over the last 4 or 5 years, I've sold a lot of new construction. I know what to look for, the good, the bad, and the ugly. So I can save you time and money and help give you a little bit of extra peace of mind. Buying a home, whether it's a resale or new construction, is so exciting, scary, fun, and nerve-wracking, and you don't have to go it alone. So if you have any questions about new construction, whether it's the financial side or the process, give me a call. I'd be happy to talk you through it. Knowing what to anticipate can help to alleviate some of the fear and those jitters. Now, if you're watching this video, you're on social media somewhere, so please follow, like, or subscribe to my social media platforms. And if you're on YouTube, be sure to hit that notification bell. Thanks for watching. I'm Jill Thomas with Berkshire Hathaway Home Services, Florida Realty.